everyone, it's Matt, reviewing something I don't normally review every day, but I've had this in the house for the last couple weeks. This is the Definitive Technology BP-9060 three-way tower speaker. The speaker is quite the behemoth, as you can see. It stands just a shade over 3.5 feet tall, 6 inches wide, and 1 foot deep. And I'll be reviewing two of them, obviously, the left and right speakers. Comes with a 2x1-inch tweeter, 3x4-inch mid-range speaker, 10-inch self-powered subwoofer. Around the back, there's a fairly standard rotary pot for you to adjust the bass on your speaker, which Definitive Technology calls intelligent bass control. The speakers fire up to 300 watts of power out with a forward-focused bipolar array. And what that means is that it tries to give you as centered of an audio experience as possible with a multi-directional sound experience. All right, let's play. I've taken the liberty of unboxing one of the speakers and hooking the stand up, and I'm going to do that for the second one on a video after this, but I just wanted to show you what the back of this looks like. So this is where you're going to be hooking your speakers up to the receiver. If you already know how to do it, just skip ahead. And if you don't, I'm just going to quickly mention that this is your plus terminal, your minus terminal, making sure when you're hooking these up to your receiver that they match on the other end as well, and that you've matched the plus and minus terminal there. This does also come with a self-powered subwoofer. So I haven't hooked it up here because I'm going to demo it with and without. The speaker can get power without you plugging it in. You just don't get the full rich features of the subwoofer. And then there is a low frequency input, which is optional, typically reserved for that full home theater experience when you're watching movies and Blu-rays. And honestly, if you're going to be buying speakers that are this high quality, my recommendation would be that you do get the full experience, that you do get the LFE wire and hook that up to your receiver as well. So what I've done here is I have set something just quickly up on the floor to do a little bit of an unorthodox demo. I pulled my receiver out just to test the speakers before I put them into place, because these things are heavy. They're about 50 pounds a piece. And so next up, I'm just going to do a quick demo of the sound off the one speaker, and then I'm going to hook everything up back to my TV and just start watching some movies and things. All right, let's do demo number one, which is the speakers powered directly from the receiver, no independent power source, which means that the subwoofer isn't being used to its fullest capabilities. And I'm going to demo it with the song Danger Zone by Kenny Loggins, because everybody loves the song Danger Zone, right? Okay, demo number two. This time I have plugged the subwoofer in, and I think you're going to hear a significant difference, and I hope it really picks up on this video. So I hope you heard a significant difference. I've actually been, I tested this with a few 90s rap songs, none of which are really appropriate for this video. So I had to go with something that I figured was safe. I also wanted to show how you could tinker with the bass settings on this once it's plugged in as well. And as you can see, there's an auto power light. I'm going to flip this to minimum and just play some music here, and then I'm going to slowly turn it up, and hopefully you can hear the difference in the amount of bass. So that's just off one speaker. I can't wait to hear how this is going to sound with both speakers going at the same time. And that's what we're going to be doing next, is unboxing and putting together the second speaker. Now, by putting together, there's literally no assembly required outside of putting the bass on this bass here.
But one thing that's that you're gonna see, well, that has been recommended, is that you flip the box upside down. So this box has to be flipped upside down here, and then you assemble the base, and then you flip it back up and pull the box up, and then things will be good to go. All right, I've cracked open the box and taken off the styrofoam. So as you can see, the speaker's actually upside down right now, and you can see four little holes here. These are holes for where you're going to be mounting the stand. Stand is in here, and I'm just going to pull this box out, put that on the floor, and show you what's inside. Let's peel back the layers here. Okay, here's your instructions. This is the stand itself. So a couple pieces here that we've got. We've got the screws and the lock rings up there, and then these are going to be mounted to the bottom of the stand and will help you determine, kind of based on where you're setting your speakers up, whether it's on the floor, whether it's on carpet, what you're going to do and how you're going to keep them in place. So if you've got hardwood floors, you obviously can't use these. These are carpet spikes, so you'll be putting these underneath the stand. And if you've got, let's say, fairly deep carpets, then you're definitely going to want to use the carpet spikes. I with the with the with the first speaker, I just left these on because I have really thin pile carpet, and the spikes really they're not useful. So if you have deep plush carpets, you probably want to use the carpet spikes here. But someone like me, I've got really kind of thin pile carpet. I'm just gonna stick to these. Okay, so I flipped the stand upside down. I've put the four screws on, and now it's just time to screw these in. So I'm just gonna do that and come back with the floor glide pieces. Okay, with the stand here in place, it's time to go to the floor glide. So here's the floor glide. There's four of them, so they go on the different ends of the stand. These lock rings here, I don't know if these lock rings are necessary, to be honest with you, because unless you want to add a little bit of height to your speaker. So what I've done is I've installed with a lock ring, and that's where it kind of locked in place. And without a lock ring, definitely do want to put these down, especially if you're going to be putting these on hardwood floors, because otherwise it's unprotected. So that's probably a good spot for why you'd want to use the lock ring. As I mentioned, I'm going with the glides here because my carpet's not deep enough to support the carpet spikes, and that's my next step here. Okay, so I flipped the box over and undid the drawstring bag, pulled all the cardboard off, pulled all the styrofoam off. So it's now time to finish unveiling this. And here we go. Looks good. One thing I did want to show you is that there's a hidden panel here. So if we push that down and pull this out of place, there is a space for another speaker here. And what this is a hidden panel here for a Definitive Technologies A90 speaker that kind of sits on top of here and actually adds more to your Dolby DTS experience. So those are optional. They are sold separately. This is one of the four 9000 series speakers that exist. So on the first three models, the A90 is available and sold as a separate module. On the 9080 series speaker, that's done. I believe that the A90s actually come built in, or some form of them actually come built in. Gonna do some audio testing now with both of the speakers in place. I don't know how well they're gonna come across on the video, but let's try. I was a little bit ambitious assuming that a straight video could properly capture what these speakers sound and feel like. It really doesn't do it justice. I would recommend walking into your local Best Buy home theater area to see if they have these hooked up to demo in their brand store area so you can get the full feel. I should mention, I did go through two receivers for this review to test things out. The first receiver was what I used in the original Danger Zone demo. However, when I got both speakers hooked up to the TV, I went in favor of a newer receiver with better capabilities, and honestly, I found the difference to be noticeable. These have been sitting in my living room now for a couple weeks, and I'll soak up as much time as I have with them. These are far and away the best speakers I've ever had at home, and they might just be the best speakers you'll ever bring home too.
In closing, I'd just like to say that for the full experience, make sure you do check out some of the other Definitive Technology speakers. You can buy a separate center speaker, you can buy separate rear speakers, and as I mentioned, you can buy the A90 add-on. Now, I will say the A90 add-on is not for sale at Best Buy Canada right now. Doesn't mean that it won't be in the future. But this was a look at the Definitive Technology BP-9060 three-way tower speaker. Thanks for watching the review. My name is Matt. Please subscribe to this channel for more audio reviews like this one and my usual run of smart home and dash cams and things. We'll see you next time.